Computational clusters are the workhorses of giant-scale services. Any modern data centers employs on the order of thousands and thousands of computational nodes connected by high-performance, high-speed networks. It is such computational clusters which are serving as the workhorses for giant-scale services today. And this figure reproduced from Eric Brewer's paper, circa 2000, shows the number of nodes in a data center maybe on the order of 1,000, but scale it up by 10 or 100 in terms of today's computational capacity that you might find in a typical data center and the kind of volume of queries that are going to be handled by giant-scale services today. Each node in the cluster may itself be an SMP. There are several virtues for structuring the computational resources inside a data center as a cluster of machines connected by high-performance backplanes. The advantages include absolute scalability. You can keep adding more resources without worrying about re-architecting the internals of the data center. Cost and performance is another important issue, and that is by having computational clusters where every node is identical to others, is that as a system administrator, we can control both the cost and the performance of running a data center like that. And because they're independent components, you can easily mix and match generational changes in the hardware. And there is also incremental scalability. You add more resources, you get more in terms of performance. Because, as I told you earlier, most of the queries that come into giant scale services tend to be embarrassingly parallel. So the more resources you've got, the more queries you can handle. There is incremental scalability when you're using clusters because you can add more nodes to the cluster, increases the performance. Or if the volume of requests come down, you can scale back. That's the advantage of using computational clusters as the workhorses for data centers that are serving giant scale services today.